Hello everyone, welcome to the next lecture on the heat equation. Today I will explain you how you can solve the various examples related to the heat equation. This is the part 1 of this various example. Myself Dr. Harishkar, you can follow my YouTube channel and subscribe it so that you can get the notification in advance. So what is the objective is, whenever you have the heat equation is also called as the diffusion equation. In this heat equation, U is called as the displacement, X is my time, and X is my position, and T is my time. Then what is your target? Your target is to find the displacement at the position X and at the time T. So this is basically your target. Then the question arises is, how you can find this, how you can achieve this target. For that we need some initial conditions. I call as U initial point, that is a 0, comma T is my 0, and this case. Now this f of x, which is unknown to us, fine. So based on this unknown nature of the fx, we can discretize these examples into the two categories. First category, when the function is of the form trigonometric function, that means whenever fx is my trigonometric form. And second category is when f of x is my polynomial form, that is whenever trigonometric form like sine cube, cos 2x, 3 times sine of this, and many more, while the polynomial is nature of this category. Now in this lecture I will explain you all those questions which is related to the type 1. You can see sine cube, sine x, cos square, 5 times of this, and many more. So in this lecture I will explain you how you can solve the type 1. After this lecture I will explain you how you can solve the problems with the help of the type 2 category. So I hope you can subscribe my YouTube channel so that you can get the notification in advance. So what is the step is, I have explained you the 3-step rule, a very simple step rule for any kind of the problem. The step number one is, you have to consider the function u, or the u, as the product of the two function, that is x. The capital X is the function of, capital X is the function of the x only, that is a small x, and capital T is the function of small t only. For example, if I say my function will be of e raised to power minus 4t sine of say this, then what is the meaning of that? This is my capital X and this is my capital T. So once you can find this u, then our target is to look at these initial conditions, then look at only those conditions whose RHS is my 0, that is the right hand side is 0, like this and this. So in the step number 2, you have to apply all those conditions whose right hand side is my 0, and in the last case you have to apply this remaining conditions. So let me explain you how you can solve this with the help of the numerical examples. Now look at this first question, which is a heat equation. Fine, always remember, you have to firstly listen one first or second example deeply without writing on your copy. Just try to understand what is the simplest way I will explain you in this lecture, and then you can write as per your convenience. So now what is given to you, now you can see this is my sine form, that is a trigonometric form which is the category of type 1. So what is the step number 1? I can start from the u, which is of x into t, where x is a function of the x and t is a function of t. I can substitute this value u in this equation number 1. What is the partial derivative of u with respect to t? That is x t prime, which is c square. Double derivative of u with respect to x is x double dash of t. Fine. Now I can make the pair of x on the left hand side and t dash on the right hand side. Fine. Now you can see on this left hand side is a function of x only, while on the right hand side is a function of the t only, and both are equal. So this condition is happen only when both are my constants, because one is a function of the x, say f of x, second is a function of the g of the t, and both are equal only when it is my constant. So I call this constant is my lambda. So for example, say lambda. Fine. Then you can write the equation, that is x double dash minus lambda x is 0, that is from first and the third terms, and from the second and the last term you have to take this. Now from this case, you have to, what is the value of the lambda? Fine, because it is a constant. It is a constant. So what is the possible cases for the constant? It can be zero, it can be greater than zero, or it can be less than zero. So let's firstly case this one. When lambda is equal to zero, you can substitute this value in here. You will get x double dash is zero and t dash is equal to zero. Fine. How you can find the solution of this? You can see it's a differential equation. So that we have studied in our earlier course. That is a differential equation. That is m square is zero. So m will be zero and zero. So capital X will be c1 plus c2 x. Similarly for this, t dash is zero. That means if you write in the auxiliary equation, so m will be zero, capital T will be c3. Hence, once you know the x and t, you can substitute this value at the point of u, you will get this solution. Now, I can apply the initial condition. What is given to you? U of t is zero. And another term, that is a zero on the right hand side, is this term. So if I apply this condition, that means x will be zero. You will get c2 and c3 zero. And from this case, I can substitute x is my pi. So you will get c1 plus c2 pi into c3 is my zero. Now c2 and c3 are zero, so it means c1 and c3 is also zero. So what is the meaning of that? C2 and c3 zero, c1, c3 zero. What is the value of the u, x, comma t? That is my zero. So that means it is constant and it is a zero. So therefore this solution is discarded. Then it means lambda is equal to zero is not possible. Then we consider the second case. That means lambda is my greater than zero. Fine. So I can simply take, when lambda is greater than zero, I can say it's a k square. Fine. K can be any real number. Then it is always positive. I can substitute this value of lambda in this equation. So this is k square of x zero and t star minus k square of capital T zero. Remember, whatever the problem is there, you have to define the case 1, case 2, case 3. Now, can you find the solution of this? It will be m square minus k square 0. So m will be plus minus k. So capital X will be c1 e raised to power kx plus c2 e raised to power minus kx. For this case, what is my m? Minus c square, k square is 0. M will be my c square, k square. That is called as auxiliary equation. So capital T will be my c3 e raised to power c square k square into t. Fine. Now I can substitute this x and t again. In this case, you will get the solution as this one. Now you can see that what is the value of this? What will happen if t approaches infinity? Because the value of t is my greater than zero, I need u should be zero. What is the value of, when t approaches infinity, u is not going to the zero. So therefore, this case is also discarded. Then we consider the third case. When lambda is my less than zero, that means I can take lambda is my minus k square. I can substitute the value of lambda at these two points. So can you find the solution of this? So clearly say it is m square plus k square is zero. M will be plus minus k iota. So that means it is a c1 cos kx plus c2 sin kx. For this case, what is the equation? Auxiliary equation is m plus k square is 0. So m will be minus k square. So capital T will be my c3 e raised to power minus k square. Sorry, it is a c square also. So it's a c square. Fine. So it's a k square c square into t. So I can substitute this x and t at the point of u. You will get this is the required expression. Fine. Now, because this is the third case, so our target. Now in this u function, you can see how many unknown parameter you have. You have the c1, c2 and k. So your target is to find the value of c1, c2 and k. So therefore, now you can see I can multiply this c1, c3. I can multiply this. I can call c1, c3 as another constant, c2, c3 as another constant. So my solution will be of this nature. Fine. Now, अब एनी क्वेश्चन यू हैव टू सॉल्व अप टू दिस इन अ सिमिलर मैनर. नाउ व्हाट इज माय स्टेप नंबर टू, यू हैव टू अप्लाई ऑल दोज कंडीशंस हुज राइट हैंड साइड इज माय जीरो. सो दैट मीन्स दिस टर्म एंड दिस टर्म. सो योर टारगेट इज टू फाइंड दिस क्वांटिटी. सो व्हाट विल हैपन, दैट मीन्स x इज माय जीरो. इफ आई सब्स्टिट्यूट x इज जीरो, इट इज माय c1. साइन जीरो इज जीरो, इट इज e रेस टू पावर माइनस k स्क्वायर t इज जीरो. फाइन. सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ दैट, दिस मीन्स इधर c1 इज जीरो और e रेस टू पावर माइनस k स्क्वायर c स्क्वायर t इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो व्हाट विल हैपन इफ दिस इज जीरो, देन व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ द u, बिकॉज दिस इज जीरो द कंप्लीट वैल्यू विल बी जीरो. सो दैट मीन्स दिस इज नॉट पॉसिबल. इफ c1 इज जीरो, क्लियरली से यू इज माई नॉन जीरो, बिकॉज इफ सी वन इज जीरो स्टिल यू हैव दिस टर्म. सो वट डज इट इम्प्लाइज, दिस इम्प्लाइज ओनली सी वन विल बी जीरो. नाउ इन दिस केस आई हैव टू सब्स्टिट्यूट एक्स इज माई पाई, सो इट विल्स सी वन कॉस के पाई प्लस सी टू साइन के पाई इन टू ई रेस टू पावर माइनस के स्केयर सी स्केयर ऑफ टी जीरो. What is the value of C1 is 0. So this number will be 0. The quantity will be this term. So what does it mean? It means either C2 will be 0, either sin of k pi will be 0, or e raised to power minus k square c square t is 0. Again, this quantity can never be 0, because if this is 0, the whole u will be 0. This is again can never be 0, because if C2 is 0, C1 is already 0, so again u will be 0. The and is a sine k pi. There is no term involving the sine k pi. It's a sine kx. Remember, it's a kx, but it's a k pi. So what does it implies? This means sine k pi will be 0. So what is the value of the k pi? K pi will be n pi, where n is 0, 1, 2, and so on. So k is my n. Fine. Now I can substitute this C1 and K at this point. So this number will be 0. This number will be U is C2 sine NX e raised to power minus N square C square T. So I denoted this constant as a DN. Fine. Now I can apply the principle of supervision, because for the each value of the N, you have the different solution. Now you can apply the last condition. What is the last condition is? What does the last condition say? That means t is equal to 0. I can substitute t is equal to 0 in this case. This value will be my sine cube. This number is left hand side is my sine cube. This number is my, when t is equal to 0, its number is my 1. This case. Now you can open this bracket on the right hand side. It is a d1. When n is equal to 1, it's a sine x. When you take d, n is 2, then it's a d2 sine 2x. Plus d3 sine 3x and so on. On the left hand side, you can see it's a sine cube. And we all know what is the formula for the sine 3x. It is 3 sine x minus 4 sine cube x. Can you find the value of this sine cube? It comes to be 3 sine x minus of this. Now you can comparing the coefficient. What is the coefficient of d1? D1 is the coefficient of the sine x, 3 by 4. What is the coefficient of the D2? Sine 2x. There is no sine 2x. What is the coefficient of the D3? Sine 3x, minus 1 over 4. What is the D4? 0. What is the D5? 0. And all the other terms are my 0. Now, therefore, the final solution will be, I can substitute all those values at this point. So my final solution is u x comma t is, when I substitute n is equal to 1, it's a d1. D1 is my 3 over 4. E raised to power n is 1. C square sine x. When I substitute n is equal to 2, d2 is a 0. When I substitute n is equal to 3, then 3 square, that is a 9. C square t sine of 3x is the right answer of this problem. Look at the second example. Now I have to again do the same procedure as I explained the example number one. Again, you can see this is the trigonometric function. So this is my type 1. So how you can start? I can start from the u is equal to x of del. I can substitute this value in this case. What is that? This is x t dash double derivative of this. Fine. I can take x on the left hand side and t on this side. Fine. Now you can see both are the constants. It here. Now again I can write the equations. It will be lambda x is 0, and from the t it will be this case. Again you have the three different cases. The case 1 is when lambda is 0, case 2 when lambda is greater than 0, case 3 when lambda is less than 0. So let's firstly do the case 1. When lambda is 0, I can substitute the value of lambda at this point. You will get x double dash 0 and t dash 0. Fine. Can you write the equation again? So x will be, again, what is the auxiliary equation for the x? It's a m square. So that means m is my 0, 0. So c1 plus c2x. For this, it is my c3. So therefore, u will be, I can substitute x and t at this point. Now apply those all those conditions whose RHS is my 0. That means, what is the partial derivative of u with respect to x? It's a c2, c3. Now, what does it mean? 0, comma t is 0. That give you c2, c3 is 0. Fine. What is the second case? X u comma t is, sorry, pi comma t is 0. Again, it give you c2, c3 is 0. Fine. So if I substitute here, what is the value of the u? If I substitute c2 and c3 here, 0. So what is my u is c1, c3, which is a constant number. Fine. So if it is a constant number, it can never be sine cos square. So therefore, this case is discarded. Fine. Look at the second case. When lambda is greater than 0, that means lambda is my k square. I can substitute this value of k square at this point. Again, you can write the solution. This is auxiliary equation is m square minus k square. You will get the solution is this form. I can substitute both the values at this point u. You will get this equation. Again, clearly say as t approaches infinity, u is not goes to the constant, or the derivative will not be 0. So therefore, the solution is discarded. Always the case 1 and case 2 will be discarded. Now look at the third case. When lambda is less than 0, that means lambda is my minus k square. I can substitute this value of lambda in these two points. You will get this equation. Again, can you write the equation of this? Auxiliary equation is m square plus k square 0. So you will get c1 cos kx, c2 sin kx. And similarly from this, you will get the expression of t. Substitute these both values in the expression of the u, you will get this solution. And clearly say your target is to find the value of c1, c2 and k. Hence, what is the solution of this heat equation, also called as the diffusion equation, is I can change this c1, c3. If you multiply c1 and c3 is called as a c1, your solution will be this one. Now, what is the step number two? Your target, once you got the solution, your target is to apply all those conditions whose right hand side is my 0. Fine. Now for this case, you need to find the partial derivative with respect to x. So what is the partial derivative of this? C1k sin kx plus c2k cos kx. Now you can substitute this value. That means I can substitute x is my 0. So x is my 0, sin is my 0. This is my k c2 e raised to power minus k square t is equal to 0. Fine. Now clearly say k can never be 0, because this is the case when lambda is strictly less than 0. Again, this quantity can never be 0, because if this quantity will be 0, then the complete u will be 0. So this implies c2 will be 0, because if c2 is 0, this is my non-zero. Similarly, I can substitute here. this is the derivative at the point k. So it is minus k c1 sine k pi plus c2. So because c2 is my 0, so this quantity will be my 0 into e raised to power minus k square of t. Now again you have the different cases. K can never be 0. C1 again can never be 0 because C2 is already a 0. If C1 is 0, then whole u will be 0. This value again can never be 0 because if this is 0, then again u will be 0. So what does it implies? This implies sine of k pi will be 0. Fine. So when sine of k pi will be 0, that means k pi will be my n pi. So what is the value of the k? K is my n, where n start from 0, 1 and so. Then I can substitute this c2 and k in this equation. That is the value of u, where n start from the 0, 1, 2, 3 and I can replace dn. You can see if I substitute c2 0, this number will be 0. I got as a c1. So I call c1 is my another constant. Then because for the different value of the n, you will get the different solution. So I can add all of this by the principle of superposition. Now finally, I can apply the last equation. U x comma 0 is cos square. That means I can substitute t is equal to 0 in this equation. This value will be my 1. This number will be my cos square. So I can substitute here. I can open this summation. When n is equal to 0, it's my d0. Sorry. When n is equal to 0, it's my d0. Cos 0 is 1. D1 cos x. Fine. Plus so on. Because the right hand side is cos x. Then it's a cos of 2x. And so on. So I can write this left hand side is also in terms of 1 plus cos 2x. Now can you compare the coefficients? Now on comparison, what is the d2? That's a constant. Constant is half. What is the d1? Coefficient of cos x. There is no cos x term. What is the d2? Coefficient of the cos 2x. What is the d3? There is no terms. D4, no term, and all others are my 0. Substitute all these values in this final expression and I can open this bracket. So your solution will be ux, t. When n is equal to 0, it's a d0. D0 is my half. E raised to power 0, 1, cos 0 is 1, plus. When n is equal to 1, it's a d1. D1 is my 0, so complete 0. When n is equal to 2, d2. E raised to power n square. When n is equal to 2, it's a minus 4. Cos n is my 2. While rest all the values are my 0, 0 and 0. So final answer will be half plus half. Half of e raised power minus 4t cos 2x is the right answer. Now look at the third example. Again, it's a heat equation and it is a form of the type 1. So again, I can start from here. U is my x into t. I can substitute this value in this case. Fine. Then you will get this expression. This is x of t dash and I can write here. Now again you have the three cases. The first case is when lambda is 0, you will get x double dash. What is my solution from here? C1 plus C2x and t is my this case. I can substitute this value again in this formulation. Which value has the right hand side 0? These two values whose right hand side is my 0. So what is the value of 0 and u of l comma t is my 0. So what is the expression of this? When x is equal to 0, it will give you c1 and c3 0. What is the value of this is c1 plus c2 l of c3 0. Now, if you open this bracket, c1 and c3 0. So that means c2, c3, l is 0. That means c2, c3 is my 0. I can substitute c1, c3 at this point. I can substitute c2, c3 at this point. You will get my u is 0. Therefore, this solution is discarded. Look at the second case. What is the second case? when lambda will be greater than 0. So you have to take lambda is k square, but you can see it's already k appears there. So I can use another symbol. So let's say lambda is my alpha square because k is already given in the statement. Fine. So I can use the lambda as a another symbol. I can substitute the value of lambda in these two points. You will get this again solution. Therefore, your u x comma t will be my this. Clearly say whenever whatever the value of the t as t up greater than 0, we need u to be 0. But you can see as t tends to infinity, u is not going to the 0. So therefore, this solution is also discarded. You can see in all these examples, similar solution will be there. Look at the last case when lambda is my negative. I can again substitute this value of lambda. You will get the value of x1 and xn t. Substitute this value. You will get this is my solution. And your target is c1, c2. Now it's alpha. Again, I can make this c2 and c1 as a one constant. This one. Now, your target is to again, because this is the solution, your target to apply all those equations whose right hand side is my 0. That means these two cases. So let's see. X will be my 0. I can substitute x 0. Cos 0 is 1. Sin 0 is 0. It is minus alpha square kt is my 0. Again, this term can never be 0 because if this quantity will be 0, then your complete u will be 0. So this implies c1 will be 0. Because if c1 will be 0, still you have the unknown terms c2. Now look at this expression, ul, 0. Now when I substitute l, that means x is equal to l. C1 is 0, so this value will be 0. So this value is my c2 sin alpha l. This is my alpha sin alpha l and this. Again, c2 can never be 0 because if c2 is 0, c1 is already 0, so complete u will be 0. This quantity again can never be 0 because if again it's 0, then again u will be 0. The only quantity here is sin alpha l will be 0. Fine, this is my alpha. Sin alpha l will be 0. So what is the meaning of that? If alpha l is 0, that means alpha l is my n pi and alpha will be n pi upon l. I can substitute this c1 and alpha at this expression. So c1 will be 0. So this quantity will be 0. So this is my c2 sin n pi over l into x. And this number is n square pi square over l square k into t. I call this c2 as another constant which is called as dn. Now, since it consists of more than one values, I can put as a summation of this thing. You can see I start from the 1 instead of the 0. Why? Because when you take n is 0, what is the value of this? Sine of 0 is a 0. So there is no need to write n is equal to 0. Fine. Now look at the last condition. I have to apply this case. That means when you substitute t is equal to 0, this value will be my this value. This number will be my t is equal to 0, e raised to power 0 is 1. Again, I can open this bracket, right hand side, when n is equal to 1, it's a pi x over l plus d2 sin 2 pi x over l and so on. Can you compare them? So what is the value of the d1? Coefficient of pi x over l on the left hand side is a 0. D2, coefficient of 2 pi x is a 5. Can you find the coefficient of d3? 0. D4, 0. And all these values are 0. Substitute all these values at this point. So your final solution will be u x comma t. Open this bracket. It's a d1. D1 is my 0. Plus d2. D2 is my 5. That means n is equal to 2. It's my 4 pi square over l square k into t is a sine 2 pi over l x. Plus when you take n is equal to 3, d3 is my 0, d4 is my 0 and so on. So your final answer will be 5 times e raised to power this quantity. Look at the one more questions. I hope you can like my video if you feel this is very useful for you. Now again it's a heat equation, fine, and this is the type 1 again, fine. So again I can start from the u, I can substitute this value at this point, you will get x double dash. I can write x value on the left hand side and this value on the right hand side, and it is come to be lambda. I can write the two equations from this case. Again, you have the three cases. Case one, when lambda is equal to zero. When lambda is zero, this equation will be x double dash zero, t dash zero. You can write the equations and their corresponding solution. Then once you know the solution, what is the those terms whose right hand side is my zero? Which terms has the right hand side zero? This quantity and this quantity, fine. It is, remember, not always apply the first two condition, always apply all those condition firstly whose right hand side is my zero. So this value is 0 comma t is 0 and pi comma t is 0. So when you apply the 0, x is 0, this value will be 0, c1 c3 is 0. When you apply this, it is my pi of c3 is 0. So when you apply, open this bracket, it will be c2 c3 is my 0. So c1 c3 will be 0, c2 c3 will be 0. So therefore u is my 0. Hence solution is discovered. Look at the second case. Again I have taken this as alpha because k is already present in the given statement. Now again, as I have explained in the last examples, you can find the solution. Again, you can see I need a solution to be the goes to the zero, but this solution, as t tends to infinity, u is not goes to the zero. Therefore, this solution is also discarded. Now look at the last case. When lambda is negative, again you can substitute this value, you will get this solution is simple. Now I can write the c1 and c3 as a one constant. Now again your target is to, because this again the solution, your target is to apply all those conditions whose right hand side is 0. I can substitute x is my 0. If x is 0, it will be my c1. Sin 0 is 0, it's e raised to power of this. Again, this quantity can never be 0 because if this is 0, again u will be 0. This implies c1 is 0. I can substitute the second case. C1 is 0, so this value will be 0. This will be C2 sine alpha pi e raised to power this quantity. Clearly say C2 can never be 0 because C1 is already 0. If C2 is 0, then again u will be 0. This value again can never be 0 because if this 0, again u will be 0. So what does it implies? That means sine of alpha pi will be 0. So that means alpha pi will be my n pi. So what is the value of the alpha? Alpha is my n. I can substitute this c1 and alpha at this point, this equation, you will get this term. I call c2 because c1 is my 0, alpha is my n, this is my nx, this again because it has more than one values, I can write the principle of the superposition. Again, you can see I start from n is equal to 1, but it is n is 0. Clearly say, when you substitute n is equal to 0 in this case, the answer will be my 0. So there is no need to write 0. Now the final step is you have to apply this last condition. That means I have to take t is equal to 0 in this expression, you will get this term. I can open this right hand side and then you can compare it. What is the comparison? D1 is my A, D2 is my 0, and all terms are this quantity. Substitute all those values in this case, your final solution will be x comma t. When n is equal to 1, D1 is A. When n is equal to 1, it's a minus 1 kt sine x plus. When n is equal to 2, D2 is my 0. N is equal to 3, 0, and so on. So So your final answer will be A e raised power minus kt sin. Look at the one more example which is of different nature. Now again you can see it is my heat equation. One condition is given to you which is of the form type 1. Fine. Now, but what is the equation whose right hand side is 0? It is not given to you. But if you read the statement, it is perfectly insulated. Fine. So whenever it's a perfectly insulated, it means the partial derivative of u with respect to x, what is the of length? If I say this is my road, fine. This is my x is equal to 0. The length is my pi. So that means this is my x is equal to pi. So this rate of change of the displacement with respect to the position at the point of A, A means x is equal to 0, and at the point B, that means x is equal to pi, is my g. Now you got as right hand side is 0 and one term which is of the type 1. Then again, you can start from the u is equal to x into t, substitute this value in this case, and you can, as I explained you in the last 5 examples, that you can do it by on. And after that, you will get this expression. Fine. Now, once you got the solution, then we have to apply the case of derivative. That means all those terms whose right hand side is 0. For that, I need the partial derivative with respect to x. So can you find the partial derivative of this u? Now it is quantity. Substitute this value. X is equal to 0, sin 0 is 0, it is k c2 e raised to power minus k square of t. Again, k can never be 0, this term can never be 0, k can never be 0 because this is the case corresponding to lambda is negative. So that means c2 is my 0. For this case, again, minus k c1 sin alpha, sorry, k pi plus c2 is 0 e raised to power minus of k square t. Clearly say c1 can never be 0 because c2 is already a 0. C1 is 0, then u is 0. This value again can never be 0. So this implies sine of k pi is my 0. That means k will be my n. Then substitute c2 and k in this expression, you will get this term. Because what is the value of the n? Let me see, n is my 0, 1, 2, 3. So n is my 0, 1, 2 and so on. Now I can, because this has more than one value, I can. Now you can see, I have taken n is 0 because what is the value of the n 0? If you substitute n 0, it's a 1. It's this quantity has some value. That's why I have taken n is my 0. Then the last case is, I have to consider this trigonometric function. So I can substitute this value at t is equal to 0. So I can open this bracket on the right hand side. When you take n is equal to 0, cos 0 is my 1 and so. Now if you compare them, d0 is the constant term, 0. D1 coefficient of the sine cos x, 0. D2 coefficient of the cos 2x, 1. Rest of the terms are my 0. Substitute all these values in my this equation, your solution will be x comma t. When n is equal to 0, d of 0 is a 0. When n is equal to 1, 0. When n is equal to 2, it's a d2. When n is equal to 2, e raised to power 2 square, that's a 4 cos 2x, while rest d3, d4 all are my 0. So your solution will be e raised to power minus 4t cos of 2x. I hope you can like my video and subscribe my channel as well. So this is the way you can solve all these questions in a very simple manner. We will see the next lecture again on the heat equation which is of the type 2 when you have a polynomial terms. I hope you can like, share and comment on my video. You can share this video with your friends. Best of luck, students. Happy learning.